Hi guys, my name is Julia and this week I tried 5 different free at-home workouts. If you want to see how it went, make sure you stay tuned till the end of the video. So the workouts that I'll be trying and reviewing will be Blogilates, Yoga with Adrian, Fitness Blender, MadFit, and Pop Sugar. Hi guys, welcome to day one. So today's Monday and we're going to be following Blogilates for today's workouts. So Blogilates is run by Cassie Ho. As you can see, she likes to do a lot of HIIT videos and a lot of Pilates videos, which is what she's known for. So for today's workout, I chose a 5-minute warm-up, her 10-minute lower ab flattener, her 12 minutes to toned abs, and her 10-minute ab and oblique sculptor. So today is an ab day, so let's see how it goes. So each of her videos had about 6 to 10 different exercises, and it was about 45 seconds to 90 seconds of work with 15 seconds of rest in between. What I found really helpful was she had a lot of modification options, so like using the Pilates stance. So what I really liked about Blogilates' channel was that her videos are typically about 10 minutes long, which is really helpful, so you can pick and choose which workouts you want to do and make your own combination. I'm shaking. But what I also found on her channel is that she also has, I guess I'll just show you in like the screen here, but she also has these playlists. So depending on what day it is, or if you want to do like a butt workout or an ab workout, she has a playlist set for you. So you can just follow the workouts that she has listed there. So I just finished all 3 of her workouts. And what I definitely like about Cassie's video is that during her videos, she's super engaging. She's constantly talking to you and keeping you motivated, which helps me a lot because one of my biggest struggles when I'm working out at home is that I'm not really motivated. Because at the gym, you know, you're in the mood. Like, there's air conditioning, there's people, like, working around you, like, there's mirrors, so, like, you can stare at yourself. Because, I don't know, like, when I stare at myself in the mirror at the gym, for some reason, I feel more motivated to keep working out. So when I'm at home, I definitely find that sometimes I don't push myself as far as I normally would. So I really like that she's super motivating and talks you through it, tells you to keep going, because I find that really helpful. And also she has like a whole bunch of really nice stories that you get to listen to while you work out with her. So yeah, overall, I would rate this workout like a 10 out of 10. Her personality was really great. Her workouts were really good. She had a whole bunch of modifications, like the Pilates stance, which is like, it was so hard. Oh my goodness, my abs are weak. And she definitely has the options of weight. And I also went through her channel and she also has like apartment friendly options, HIIT options, which is something I definitely think I'm gonna try in the future. Hello everybody. Now it's day 2 and we're going to be doing yoga today. I don't really feel like working out. My abs are low-key kind of sore from yesterday with Cassie, but we're here, we're gonna do it. So yeah, let's go. So today we're going to be following a video from Yoga with Adrian. Her videos are mainly about yoga, in which she has yoga videos for different purposes, like stretching, stress, ab strength, and she also has some meditation videos. The workout I chose to follow today from her was her yoga for weight loss. So I'm super excited, let's get straight into it. So this workout started off lying on the floor, so that was really nice and relaxing to start. What I noticed right away with her videos was that right from the beginning, she was constantly giving instructions about tips about technique and breathing, which I found super helpful. So then that I didn't have to turn my head to look at the screen too often. So I felt that her workout was a mix of, I don't know what you would call it, like yoga poses, so kind of more stretching poses, and then she would also incorporate some holds that would really engage your abs, which I found really difficult. So I just finished her workout, and that was slightly more challenging than I thought it would be. The biggest struggle that I had was actually holding the poses for extended periods of time. And I had some deja vu today because we also went into like the Pilates stance, the one where you're like, whoo, and you have to keep like your upper abs clenched because we did that yesterday in Vlogilates video. So yeah, I found that really challenging for this video. But what I really liked about her videos was that her tone of voice was super relaxing, which I guess is really fitting for yoga. She feels very authentic when I listen to her, so I really enjoyed that. And another thing that I found really helpful with her was that she was constantly giving instructions, as I mentioned before. So reminding you to be conscious of like your body, making sure that you're squeezing your abs when you're doing the plank and you're not dipping too high or going up too high. She was super duper good. I really liked her, and I definitely think I'm gonna be trying out her yoga for flexibility because she's just really great. It was a lot harder than I thought it was going to be, okay? For some reason, I don't know why people think yoga is easy, because maybe beginner's yoga is easy, but this yoga was difficult. Hi guys, so now it's day 3. Today we're going to be following MadFit. I'm really excited because today we're going to be doing one of her weighted workouts, and we haven't done any weighted workouts yet this week. So her videos are mainly at-home workouts, and she offers a lot of no equipment options, which is really great if you're stuck at home. And what I think is really cool is that she has some song/dance workouts, which is what I believe she got popular for. So for today's workout, I'm going to be following her 10-minute toned arms workout at home quick burn, and her 10-minute toned arms workout at home minimal equipment, as well as her 11-minute cardio abs. And we also have a little bit of a change of scenery. Right now we're in my home basement gym kind of thing because we have some weights down here. So for this video, I'm going to be using these 3-pound dumbbells. We have heavier ones, but the heavier ones are too heavy. It's like a really big jump. So today we're just going to be using these bad boys. So for the 2 toned arm workouts, we start off with some 30-second intervals of warm-ups. Okay, so I just finished her first workout. For the second video, I'm actually gonna switch to some slightly heavier dumbbells just because, I don't know, the 3 pounds were a lot lighter than I thought it would be because, you know, I'm more thick than I thought I was. So we're gonna switch to these bad boys now. Then after that, for the majority of the video, we did 60-second intervals of back-to-back body weight exercises like push-ups, as well as weighted exercises like shoulder presses. And then for her cardio abs, we did intervals of 30 seconds on and 15 seconds off of different ab cardio moves like mountain climbers. Hey guys, so I just finished her workout. So 3 things that I definitely really liked about her videos was, number 1, her workouts don't necessarily require weights, which is really helpful if you're at home. Like, her cardio abs definitely got my heart rate going even without having to like actually run or do any jumping, which is really nice. I also really like that her videos, for me, it felt more structured. She would tell you ahead of time how long you'd be working out for, when your breaks were, what the intervals was, so you would know what to expect. And also she had some really good like background music and an overall like ambiance and an aesthetic to her video, which I think is a really nice touch to it. Overall, I really enjoyed her videos. One thing that I would do differently next time though is have maybe 2 or 3 different sets of weights with me, just because for her first 2 videos with the toned arm weights, I found that some of the workouts I could only use the 3-pound weights, like with the flies, whereas with the other workouts such as, I don't know, like the shoulder press, I found I could use a heavier weight. So just having those options makes it easier, so you're always pushing yourself. But yeah, that's the end of day 3. We're halfway through, guys. Hi guys, welcome to day 4. Today we're going to be trying Pop Sugar Fitness. So on their channel, they have a variety of different workouts. I noticed that they're all mostly 30-minute workouts, and they have a huge variety from kickboxing, HIIT, to even bar workouts. And for day 4, the video that I tried to follow was This Killer Workout Torches Calories, about 545 minutes. So this workout was much more fast-paced and high-intensity compared to the other workouts that we did this week. All the moves were basically back-to-back. What I noticed about the moves that we did was they were much more unique in a way that the instructor had a whole bunch of combinations. So like we had like this squat, kick, punch movements, and we also had a whole bunch of different shuffling and jumping moves, which helped get your heart rate up. So I just finished her workout, and honestly, I really love the energy that the instructor was giving off. She was super vibrant, and like the two other people in the back were giving me like 80s workout vibes. Like, it was super motivating watching the video. The moves I felt were like super unique or like non-traditional workout moves, because we did like a lot of kicks and punches, which is something that I don't normally do in my workouts. Overall, it was like a really great workout. You didn't need any weights at all, and like I'm definitely like really sweaty. And I didn't even touch a single weight. We just did like a lot of jumps and kicks and like a lot of different ab movements and leg movements. One thing to keep in mind though is if you're in an apartment for this workout in particular, there was a lot of jumping and shuffling. So it might be a little bit noisy if you aren't in your own house. So yeah. Hi guys, welcome to day 5. Today we're going to be following Fitness Blender. So their channel is run by Daniel and Kelly. If you don't know them, they do workouts that target all areas of your body with the use of body weight, kettlebells, dumbbells, and bands. And I think their channel is especially great if you're working out at home because nothing requires a lot of equipment. Today I'm following Pilates butt and thigh workout for glute activation. So this workout was completely weight-free. The structure was very fluid, so we repeated the same set of workouts 3 times. The first round with 5 reps, the second round with 8 reps, and the last round with 12 reps. All the moves only required the space on the mat, which is great if you have a very tight space to work out in. And also, it did have the option of making it more difficult by adding ankle weights, bands, or different modifications. So I really like this workout. I'm not sweaty and my heart isn't racing because this video was more of a slow burn. And I really like that it hit different parts of my glutes. I think this video is very great for beginners because they really emphasize form and breathing. And it's very repetitive, so you can catch on really easily. Also, I really liked how structured the video was with the rounds and the reps because I was able to mentally prepare myself for the next move so then I could keep going. Overall, I would highly recommend their Pilates videos. I'm so grateful for these fitness professionals who have created these free at-home workouts that are accessible in terms of equipment, space, and are super motivating and really helpful in keeping you active at home. I would absolutely recommend everyone that's featured in this video. And if you enjoyed this video, make sure to like this video and hit the subscribe button. And I'll see you guys in the next one. Peace!